r/AskReddit by Planet Reddit. Identical twins of Reddit. What's the most embarrassing situation where you've been mistaken for your twin? A friend and his wife go to the same supermarket every week. His identical twin also goes there with his wife. One day, after summoning up the courage, the cashier pulls my friend's wife aside and says, "I'm sorry to have to tell you this, but I've seen your husband here several times with another woman." "Oh, you mean his other wife? Maria?" "Yeah. We have split custody. I get him Monday and Wednesday. She gets him Tuesday and Thursday. Weekends alternate." "Holy crap, that's awesome. He gets Friday off." My friend said hi to his brother one morning. Well, it turns out his brother was actually his own reflection in a window. His mom witnessed it and has never let him live it down. My brother and I both entered into the science fair. Before the award ceremony, he got sick. So I went with just my mom. My brother won first place and I didn't place at all. When they called his name, my mom made me go up for him. I stood on a stage, looking out at the sea of friends and teachers clapping for me while a medal was hung over my shoulders and a certificate was shoved into my hands. In the moment, I should have felt proud of my brother. But instead, I just started crying on stage and weirded everybody out. I think they must have thought I was just overwhelmed with happiness. Because even when I stepped off of the stage and made a beeline for the back door, people continued to congratulate me and try to shake my hand. Congratulations. My twin's name. It was such a bizarre emotion. Like a blend of jealousy and shame. I walked straight to the back, past my mom, and left. AWH. This was actually really sad. I'm picturing you being like 10 years old and not knowing how to process. If you're a twin, you're bound to eventually have a few embarrassing stories. My whole life has been a system of awkward hugs or ducking a kiss from a girl and yelling, "Wrong one. Wrong one." Brother's girlfriend jumps in your lap while you're watching movie. It happens. My personal favorite has to do with situations that have occurred due to mistaken identity with my brother now that he is a Marine officer. I joined the Peace Corps shortly after he became an officer, yay. We're a sitcom setup. And worked as a teacher in Eastern Europe. Over drinks at a dinner during my service with friends of my host family. One of the gentlemen tells me that he used to be a Soviet helicopter pilot and asks me if I'd like to see his uniform. He brings down the full outfit in all its medale glory. We're almost exactly the same size. And he lets me try it on. Thinking how cool this is, I post a picture online wearing it to show everyone. My brother calls me a few days later pissed as all hell because during his screening for a security clearance someone finds pictures of him wearing perfectly tailored Soviet regalia. He yells at me for getting brass up his ass and complains that he might get his clearance postponed. We still laugh about it. We found this photo. You communist sympathizer. Confess. No, you don't understand, that's my brother. So you have family ties to communists. Egg. I don't see why they'd be so upset. A Marine with a twin brother who's a Soviet soldier? Well, that's an action movie just begging to happen. A while back when I was in middle school, I went over one of my good friend's house. His mom comes in. We start talking about random stuff. Then she asks my name. I had known this woman for 5-6 years at this point, so I was pretty damn confused. The conversation continues for a very awkward minute or two. Then my friend's mom walked in. Didn't even know she had a sister till that day. How did it not occur to an adult twin to introduce herself to a child she had never met before? I do not believe I could pass up the absolute panty twisting that could do to a person. Not an identical twin. But I worked retail for a few years. And had a lot of regular customers. This one girl would come in and she was awesome. She loved the product. Always made conversation over what she was doing. What she had done. We always connected. Sometimes she would initiate the conversation. Sometimes I would. Never really learned her name though. Which is pretty embarrassing in sales. About a year and a half after knowing her, she walks in one day and I wave to her. She excitedly waves back. All of a sudden, a perfect ducking clone, in a similar outfit but different colors, walks out from behind her. My jaw literally dropped. I was in disbelief. I had been talking to two twin sisters thinking they were the same person for over a year. When I asked why they never pointed it out to me, one goes, "Well, you just seemed to talk to me like you knew me." So I went with it. Surreal experience. Honestly. When we were in the 6th grade, my brother decided he wanted to stay at home because he wasn't feeling well. So far, there had never been a day where only one of us was at school, but I didn't think anything of it. I was walking down the hall and all of a sudden I was pulled in by a teacher who I had never seen before, and she started yelling at me, and I mean yelling at me, because I had skipped her class and I had the audacity to walk in front of her class right after. It was really awkward to just say, "UHH. I have an identical twin brother. My name is Jay Sweat." She, of course, thought I was making a terrible excuse, and I had to go get another teacher that knew I had a brother to come tell her that I was telling the truth. She never bothered me again. Other than that, we've never had a super embarrassing story. Haha, the same thing happened to my twin sisters. One got busted for ditching because the other was sick. The principal complained that my mother dressed them the same, but we all wore uniforms, so it made no sense. What? I'm upset that you're adhering to the dress code. My brother and I are now 25. But in middle school, being a twin was funny embarrassing. We are one of the sets of twins who look exactly alike. Get the same haircut, and even our voices sound the same. In 7th grade, I was minding my own business in class when someone joked that I wasn't myself. Immediately everyone in the classroom and the teacher decided to investigate. Although I had all my papers with me and all my belongings, they came to the conclusion that we could have switched them. So these Harvard-educated teachers did what they thought was best. They grabbed my brother from his classroom, across the hall, and started comparing us, trying to make sure we were who we said we were. After numerous times of us assuring them we were in the right class, I couldn't help but laugh some. After my laugh, people in the classroom started to laugh and come out into the hallway with us. The teachers found this amusing that nobody knew who we were, and now 50 plus students are in the hallway trying to tell them who I was and was not. Needless to say, this ended with both of us in the assistant principal's office with a stern warning to not switch courses, even though we were in the right class. Thinking back, what a bunch of morons. Don't even get me started with girlfriends kissing and groping the wrong person in high school. Only positive was being popular by doing nothing but existing. My grandmother was an identical twin. Her sister passed away before I was born. She didn't like to tell stories from when she was little. But she did tell me one mistaken identity story. She was in their bedroom one night when they were really young and saw her sister through the window. She started talking to her sister to see why she was outside at night. Then she realized it was her reflection. My grandmother had mistaken herself for her twin. One day I was looking through her photo albums and came across some pictures of her twin in her coffin. That picture haunted me until I actually had to see my grandmother in her coffin. My twin brother had a huge stash of porno mags in his closet, and I always wondered where he got the money to buy them. One night I walked into a nearby convenience store with some friends, and the guy behind the counter threw me out. I had no idea why. When my friends asked, he told them he had caught me stealing porno mags the week before. This is interesting. I wonder how in a criminal case they could prove who was who? It puts a spin on innocent until proven guilty. Edit. Grammar. There was a murder case some time ago where the only evidence was DNA or something, and since it's identical, they couldn't prove which twin had done it, so they both got off. Edit. Word for clarity, sorry. Also, I am informed that this is now an outdated practice because they have closed the loophole via comparing base pairings of the two and finding minute differences. So that's good bad news for all you criminal twins out there. Edit 2. I'm also told this happened on Law and Order. That's cool. It also happened in real life. Sorry. Also, there are a few examples of this happened around the world. I'm told there were some jewel thieves. Also a rape case. So this has actual precedence around the world. The more you know. Edit 3. Oh, and also there were conjoined twins where one committed murder but they couldn't imprison an innocent one to make the guilty one serve his sentence, so he was not imprisoned. So I'm told. My father is an identical twin. He was mistaken for my uncle while walking with a woman hand in hand down the street in London, England. The witness was a friend of my aunt, and immediately called her to accuse her husband of infidelity. She was at that moment sitting beside my uncle in Ontario, Canada. Part of me hopes that your other aunt and uncle were in London, Ontario, because that would make the story even better. That would be the first time being in London, Ontario had ever made anything better. Obligatory edit. Gold. Top comment about London? For those below asking about or considering visiting London, follow Winston Churchill's advice. When going through hell, keep on going. Pretty sure he was talking about the 401. Some girl decided to suggest that I date a guy that looked very, very much like me. Yes. Those were her words. There's this guy who looks so much like you. You two should get together. Is his name? Name? Yeah. You've met him? Yes. That is my brother. My sister has twice tried to fix me up with two different guys. Her big selling point for both is that they look so much like my other brother. WTF. I told her she has issues. I dated a girl that looked very similar to me. We were lounging around one day when she says, "You look a lot like my brother." I think I just responded with, "Huh." I was dating a girl in college. The first time I went to her house, she opened the door. I told her I liked what she did to her hair and kissed her. She kissed me. We went inside. She then yells, "Your boyfriend is here." They were weird girls. My brother and I dated twins way back in the day. They used to do shit like this to us all the time. Ducking weird. You don't even know. Unzips. Alright. Go on. I went to a party once, and my bald identical twin bro had yet to arrive. His girlfriend was already there. So I gave her the obligatory friendly hug. Then sat on the other side of the room to hang out. This other guy, a mutual friend of his and hers, kept staring at me, then staring at her, with this real nervous WTF look on his mug, for about 15 minutes. Every so often, this guy would look around nervously and then furiously text on his phone. Then my brother arrives. He kisses his girlfriend and says hi to everyone. And this guy blows up. Jesus, was no one going to say anything? What the duck was that? I thought he grew a full head of hair in a day. Edit. People keep asking, he's bald cause he shaves his head. My hair is receding but existent. Back in high school we had a teacher with an identical twin who did substitute teaching work for our school. The only physical difference between the two of them was one sported a classy mustache. The other was clean shaven. You'd go to math in first period of the day and have Mr. K then show up in physics right after lunch and it'd appear as though Mr. K had grown a glorious Burt Reynolds in just under 4 hours. This is my favorite one so far. Not me, but a co-worker has two sets of twin daughters. The younger pair are identical and both work at the same McDonald's. The manager often puts one on the pay window and the other on the food window just to mess with customers. Oh my god. That's brilliant. Where is this? We at least need a picture. I've been called my twin sister's name my whole life. So one day I accidentally introduced myself to someone as her. When I caught and corrected myself after, they thought I was straight up crazy for not knowing my own name. If I was a twin, I'd imagine I'd do that more often than I'd like to admit. I'm not a twin, but my mom and aunt are identical twins and my girlfriend's parents own the only restaurant in my small town and they have told me how they thought my mother was having an affair. Also have had texts from friends that my mother was with another man. I send a picture of my uncle and it's always him. The long con. Your mom is having an affair with your uncle and nobody believes. What's more, the uncle doesn't even know. My father spent a year abroad before returning to enroll in the same college as his twin brother. The first few days were pretty standard. Acquaintances of my uncle mistaking my dad for him. Business as usual. That was until one girl approached him. Publicly, mind you. And with a wink said, "You were really great last night. I gave your number to a few friends. I hope you don't mind." Naturally, my dad went from there to immediately seek out and congratulate his brother on his good fortune, and hopefully share in the spoils. On the way, he found himself receiving a disproportionate level of sly smiles and sidelong glances from some of the groups he passed. By the time he finally found my uncle, he was thoroughly perplexed. Surely his brother couldn't have been this lucky. They were good-looking guys. But this was just ridiculous. My uncle flushed and faltered when confronted by my dad. He stammered and tiptoed around the issue before my dad finally got it out of him. How had he managed so prolific a penile pedigree? He hadn't. Turns out my uncle had spent all his money in the first few weeks and had turned to desperate measures for cash. He had been working as a stripper, doing mostly private parties. But naturally word got around. So for the rest of the year my father had to contend with the fact that a good number of the people on campus had effectively seen him naked. So prolific a penile pedigree. That is a beautiful example of alliteration. Life pro tip. Become stripper in college. Not me, but a good friend is a twin. I only know one of the twins well and have spoken to the brother maybe twice in 15 years. My friend is the wild twin and the brother is very laid back. I live in a big town of 100,000 plus people with plenty of pubs and clubs. My friend ended up getting barred from most of them over a period of a few months and then started drinking out of town. His twin didn't know how bad it was until he was out one night with his wife and the bouncers let him in anywhere. Much to his wife's fury. Twin tried to tell the bouncers, "It's not me. It's my twin." Didn't work at all. Eventually settled when he rang his brother. Made him come into town and go round every bar to the bouncers and prove he wasn't the band twin. They took note of his ID. Kept the ban on for my pal and let his twin go on enjoying his night. One bouncer joked with them both and said he has heard that story hundreds of times and never thought he would see the day it was true. All your friend needs to do is take his brother's ID out with him and he could get into all the clubs which he is banned from. Not an identical twin but married to one. When I was dating my wife, she and her twin sister had a bunch of friends over. I walked over to her and put my arm around her and she leaned into it. I leaned in for a kiss but then she pulled away. I thought, well, maybe she's not comfortable with a little peck in front of our friends since we hadn't been dating for too long. Then I scanned the room and made contact with my girlfriend. I looked back and all that I had my arm around her sister, who was messing with me until things went too far. I then tucked my tail between my legs, walked over to my girlfriend, put my arm around her and said, "Well, will you give me a kiss?" Smooth cover. Inside head nailed it. Not a twin but dated one of two identical twins. They used to play pranks on me where they would pretend to be the other one, switch places to test me. That all stopped when I walked up to the wrong one, grabbed onto her butt, and told her some of the very explicit things I had planned for her booty later that night. Needless to say, one twin found it hysterical while the other one less so. Pretty much for the following 3 years we dated, the other twin used to say goodnight and guard your booty every time we went to bed. Edit. Really hope my ex doesn't see this colon. Wait. Which one found it hysterical and which one was bothered by it? It could conceivably be either. Since the other twin utilized the guard your booty joke for 3 years, I would assume it was the twin whose ass was grabbed that found it funny, whilst the twin he was dating did not. Not a twin. But my boyfriend is. We were walking to class when a girl approached us. She confronted my boyfriend about why he stopped talking to her / hanging out with her. At first it was extremely awkward for me. But I figured out what was going on and laughed it off. Turns out she was a crazy girl that his brother saw talk to one time in their dorm laundry room and didn't talk again after that instance. Oh. Don't worry, babe. I'm a twin. That girl was talking about my brother, he looks just like me, you know? Cause I'm a twin. Don't put too much thought into why you've never met him. Or why I have not mentioned him until this very moment. Oh, and we don't like to be in the same place a lot, so when you meet him I won't be there. It was during those awkward middle school days and my twin sister got her first boyfriend. We had our first 8th grade dance and thought it would be so funny to switch places with each other to see if her boyfriend noticed. He didn't and proceeded to go for the big first kiss. Didn't go so well. They broke up and it was an emotional 2 weeks for my poor little twinnie. Our middle school. Prank someone. Hate them when it backfires in your face. 10/10 would date again. Middle schoolers don't exactly run off logic. Source. Was once in middle school. In my hometown there was a kid in my grade who looked almost exactly like me, being tall and redheaded. It was pretty unusual. One night I got stopped by the cops and the officer just blew up at me right away, yelling that he had warned me about what would happen if he ever saw me again and that I was going straight to jail. It didn't take me long to figure out he had mistaken me for this other kid and get things straightened out. But it wasn't the only time that happened. I hope that cop apologized. Got my brother in trouble when with his first sergeant. When I went to pick him up from his base after flying home on R&R. I was still in uniform and had a friend pick me up and take me from the airport, SeaTac, to his base. FT. Lewis. They're not that far from each other. After arriving to the base, I went to my brother's unit and asked if he was around. They just stared at me like I was crazy. Then one ran off to grab his sergeant. It pretty much kept going until I made it to his first sergeant. After making it to the first sergeant, he lost his shit and started grilling me for not wearing the right patch and wearing a combat badge. I laughed and then told them that I was his twin. Right when I finish explaining the situation, he walks in. Watching their jaws drop and move their heads back and forth was priceless. Here's my mistaken identity story with respect to my identical twin brother. We both attended the same university a long time ago, but had two different majors, so our daily schedules stayed completely distinct. School routines commence and I am attending music classes on a regular basis. In due course I start chatting up with a cute saxophone player. She and I are getting along swimmingly for a while. But in a short while I start noticing a palpable cooling off of her attitude. I shrug it off as someone giving me the back off. Not interested message and carry on with my other friends. Life goes on. So many fish in the sea. Etc. Fast forward 4 years. It's graduation day. My brother and I are dressed identically in our cap and gowns for the ceremony. We're standing there side by side while our proud parents are taking our picture. For adult twins. This is about as identical looking as you can get without coming across as creepy or lame. When all of a sudden I hear, "Oh. My. God. I thought you were the biggest snob. You talked to me in the band room like we were best friends and then ignored me in the science building like you didn't want anything to do with me." Yes. It was that saxophone player. By this point, we're both in different relationships and school is over. So there's no real point to pursue anything. But it was certainly a good laugh and makes for a good anecdote. TLDR. Accused of being a snob by a classmate because they didn't realize I had an identical twin brother. Thanks for watching. Subscribe for 3 videos a day.